So let's say that I have this little function, and it's a stupid function, but it's called soda function. It has one input A, one output Y. Okay, and then over here in the command window, notice that there's nothing in the workspace. I'll even CLC clear it just to prove it. I type A equals 12, and then I'm going to type B equals 14, and then I'm going to type T equals A plus B. So theoretically then T should come out to be 26. And then I'm going to run x equals soda function of t, okay? And it comes back with x equals 53. Okay, no big deal. And you're like, oh, okay, well, that's great. I've got an answer. This makes me happy. And you move on. Now, maybe you never even knew soda function was there. So this is all you saw. A equals 12, B equals 14, t equals A plus B, and x equals soda function of t. And I get 53, and I'm like, that's exactly what I expected out of this function. I'm so excited. And anyway, so that's what you get. Then you go, well, I want to know more about this function. You open it up, and it starts to look really scary because it has all these variables you've never heard of. But remember that that's okay, because the way that most programming languages handle functions and stuff like that is that they're local to that particular instance or function or whatever. So even though in this function it says b equals 2, you're like, but b equals 14, but that's okay, because remember that soda function has its own little separate set of variables, and in this little happy world off to the side, b is equal to negative 2. And you're like, oh, well, x is equal to a plus x, or 6, or whatever that is, but my x is 53, and that doesn't make any sense. So we're going to kind of talk about this just a little bit and try to, I guess, fortify the idea that these variables are local to the functions themselves. So this is kind of what we had. We had, in the command line, I had a equals 12, b equals 14, and t equals a plus b, soda function of t, okay. So basically what's going on is we saw whenever we hit a equals 12, it said, okay, cool, a is equal to 12, and this is in like your main. It said, okay, cool, a is 12. And then it said, oh, b is 14, yay, and then it said t is equal to a plus b, so it said t was 26. And then it said x is equal to the soda function of something. I don't know what that is. But it said it was the soda function of t. So remember that t is equal to 26. And remember that MATLAB does not pass t as a variable. It passes a value. Now it's like a little Viking helmet for opera singing. Okay. So remember that this 26 goes do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do over here. And so what this function says is this function doesn't say much of anything, but basically what it's going to do is it's going to look at that input of 26, and it's going to say, okay, a is 26. And you're like, but wait, a is 12. No, no, no. This guy is like that, the brick wall of something luminous. I don't know. What kind of walls are there? Walls of strength. There's a wall of strength. Kind of looks like a rocket. Anyway, but it's not a rocket. It's a wall. So we've got a wall, and this is a. A is 26. Why is it 26? Well, because I threw it over it, but you're like, but it was t. No, 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 no. Remember, I'm not sending over a value of t. I'm not sending over a variable t. I'm sending over, like, an actual value of 26. So I sent over 26. It's like, okay, A is 26. Yay. So A is 26. And now I'm like, okay, B is negative 2. Remember, it has no idea what's going on over here. This is like, this almost doesn't exist right now, okay? So b is negative 2, and they're like, oh, x is a plus 6, so 26 plus 6 is, I don't know, 32? There we go. I can math. All right. And then t is equal to x plus a plus b, so that's 32 plus a plus b, so it's like 30 plus 26, that's 56. So t is equal to 56. And y is equal to t minus 3. T minus 3 is 56, or 53. 56 minus 3 is 53, or whatever I said. The answer is 53. All right, and then I'm like, oh, I'm done. So what are my output? Well, my output, what are my output? My output are y. So that means that what I'm going to return is this y value. So I'm going to take y, but remember, I'm not actually taking y. I'm taking the value of 53. I put little wings on it. Horns. Flying horns. So I take the flying horns of my 53. There is no B3 bomber. And I go. Okay, and now something magic happens. As it crosses over this threshold, all of this stuff here disappears forever and ever and ever and ever. And I'm actually erasing it, so I can't even undo it later. All this is gone. Okay, did you see that habit? I can't redo it because I erased it because it's gone. But as I go from here to here, as I cross over, all that stuff gets thrown away and it's like it never existed. This, however, has existed the whole time. So that's still there. Why? Because that was the main thingy that was going on. Okay, so here's this guy and he flew because he has wings and he can get over and he goes into the 53. Okay? So, and I took Brooks with me because I'm that good. Okay, so basically what's going on here then, is that X is now equal to 53. So if someone were to ask you, well, what's the value of, you know, Y? What's Y over here? You'd be like, there is no Y. So Y does not exist. But you're like, but there was a Y over, wait, it's gone. And that's the whole point. You can't go back and see what Y was because Y is completely gone. I can ask for A, but A is exactly 12 because it's like it never even happened. And you're like, B, and B is still that. And X, X is 53. And you're like, but there used to be an X over here and it was something else. But guess what? It's gone. You can't see it. And that's the whole thing that's absolutely beautiful about whatever you call it. Local variables, how they're local to the whatever is going on. So if I go back over to MATLAB, so even though I ran the function, see I only have A, B, T, and X, 12, 14, 26, and 53, and that's exactly what I have here.